So what do all those ports get you? Well, they get you a whopping 27 million copies sold, making it the 7th best-selling game of the entire decade. It's always fun to do a countdown of the year, the best games, the worst games, but what's even better is when you get the chance to do the countdown of a decade. That is right. What is up, everybody? Chaos, today we are going to be doing the best-selling games of the decade. That's right. Games that were released between 2010 and 2019. The best-selling ones. And we're going to go back on some of these. Some of these, you're going to be like, oh yeah, I forgot about that game. So drop a like. Make sure you guys enter the PlayStation 4 giveaway. It runs the entire month, every single month. All you have to do is drop that like. Make sure you're subscribed to the channel with that little bell rung. And in the comment section, tell me what your favorite game of this decade has been and include your Twitter handle. And we kick things off with Call of Duty Black Ops. This puts a smile on my face. This is my favorite Call of Duty game. And it was released in 2010 for the PS3, the Xbox 360, the PC, and the Wii. Yeah, the Wii. It had you jumping between a couple time periods in the campaign, although the bulk of it was set during the 1960s in the Cold War. The multiplayer was great. It brought back the trends that Modern Warfare 2 helped establish, but it also slowed things down just a tad. And finally, you had the first full-fledged Zombies mode, and Zombies debuted in World at War as a little bonus, but Black Ops 1 was the first game to fully market Zombies as its third mode. The end result was an excellent and unique Call of Duty game that gave birth to the most oversaturated subseries Activision has to offer. As of 2019, Black Ops 1 has sold over 26.2 million copies, which earns it the number 10 spot today. At number 9, we have Red Dead Redemption 2. Now, you probably weren't expecting to see a game this new on the list, but here it is. It launched in late 2018 after multiple delays and a huge, huge hype train. The game actually took place before the events of the first Red Dead Redemption, but after Red Dead Revolver. Rockstar was never that good at numbering their games. It's okay. He played as Arthur Morgan, an outlaw trying to help his gang go from camp to camp safely while also uncovering various secrets about the members in the world around them and the ones that want him dead. Red Dead Redemption launched in October of 2018 on the PS4 and the Xbox One, and it managed to sell 26.5 million copies on those two platforms alone. And since then, the game has been ported to PC, but we unfortunately don't have any exact numbers on those sales yet, but I would guess probably another 2 to 4 million. I think Red Dead 2 is going to be creeping its way up the list as time goes on and people keep buying the various ports the way they did with GTA 5. At number 8, Call of Duty Modern Warfare 3, the single best-selling Call of Duty game of all time. Modern Warfare 3 launched in 2011, and it had an extremely hectic development cycle in which most of Infinity Ward resigned due to the lawsuit between them and Activision at the time. It also forced Activision to bring in Sledgehammer Games and Raven Software to desperately help them stitch the rest of this thing together in time for release. All things considered, they did a good job. And Modern Warfare 3 ended up being a fan-favorite COD title, even if early reception wasn't that warm. It had a good campaign. It wrapped up the story. It had an expansive multiplayer with the most launch content the series has ever seen to this day. And it had the return of Spec Ops, complete with a brand new survival mode. Modern Warfare 3 managed to sell a whopping 26.5 million copies on the PS3, the 360, the PC, and the Wii. At number 7, Terraria. Does anybody remember Terraria? This is a game that kind of came out of left field, and it plays kind of like a 2D mixture of Minecraft and Metroid. It was a sandbox game with pixelated graphics developed by Relogic and published by 505 Games in May of 2011. Now, it started off pretty low-key, but since then, its reputation has grown and grown, and it has more and more ports, and the sales just keep climbing. As of the recording of this video, Terraria has been released on the PC, the Mac OS, the Linux, the PS3, the PS4, the PS Vita, the Xbox 360, the Xbox One, the iOS, Android, Windows Phone, Wii U, 3DS, and the Switch. So what do all those ports get you? Well, they get you a whopping 27 million copies sold, making it the 7th best-selling game of the entire decade. So if you kind of like a peaceful vibe sandbox game like Minecraft, maybe Terraria is where it's at for you. At number 6, Mario Kart 8. Yeah, you knew it was going to be on here, at least one Nintendo game. I was actually a little surprised, though, to see This Is That One. Mario Kart 8 launched on the Wii U in May of 2014. It had good reception, excellent sales, although excellent sales on the Wii U is kind of subjective because of how poorly the console sold itself. But I digress. 3 years later, Nintendo released the Switch and quickly brought out a port for that version titled Mario Kart 8 Deluxe, which was once again met with great reception and excellent sales. So across the two versions, Mario Kart 8 has sold a whopping 27.4 million copies. And according to reports, it is the best-selling Wii game and best-selling Switch game. So I was kind of surprised to see Mario Kart 8 on the list because I figured we would get like Smash Bros. Ultimate or Breath of the Wild on here, but I guess Mario Kart has a bigger, broader appeal. At number 5, Diablo 3. Now, I don't think many people understand how big of a deal Diablo 3 was when it launched. After the game came out broken, a lot of people wrote it off. But this game was a big deal. So for context, the original Diablo came out in 96, and Diablo 2 came out in 2000. These games helped define the action RPG genre, and they garnered a massive following. But Diablo 3 entered development in 2001. Then it was delayed time and time again, getting pushed all the way back 11 years. So when the game finally did launch in May of 2012, players flocked to it. It was met with positive reception for the gameplay, but the server issues were heavily criticized as Blizzard was not expecting the game to sell that well, which resulted in servers crashing and locking people out of the game entirely. So, following the PC's version success, Diablo 3 was ported to the PS3 and the 360 in 2013, and then to the PS4 and the Xbox in 2014, and finally, the Switch in 2018. So across all the versions, Diablo 3 has sold an estimated 30 million copies. At number 4, Skyrim. I don't think even Bethesda realized just how big Skyrim was going to be. Open fantasy world RPG, fifth mainline entry in the Elder Scrolls series. You guys know it. You played as a character called the Dragonborn as you go out on a quest to learn skills and eventually become powerful enough to do battle with the World Eater, a dragon who's out to destroy the world, obviously. The story and the gameplay were met with positive reception, but what really blew Skyrim up was its replayability. There were seemingly endless things to do, and it was super easy to get lost in the game's world while venturing from place to place. It was a huge success after it launched in November of 2011 for the PC, PS3, and 360, which, of course, prompted Bethesda to start the milk train. They have re-released it so many times. In 2013 as a legendary edition on PS3 and 360, then in late 2016, they released a remastered version on PC, PS4, and Xbox One. Then in late 2017, there was a Switch port, and then there was a virtual reality version, and then, you know, it got to the point it just became a meme in the gaming world for how many times Skyrim has been re-released. But it worked out, and it has sold over 30 million copies this decade. At number 3, PUBG, one of the biggest indie success stories of all time. PlayerUnknown's Battlegrounds was first released on Steam's Early Access program in March of 2017, then it got its official 1.0 release in December of the same year. The game, it exploded. Yeah, it was super impressive considering there was little to no marketing and it was just spread by word of mouth. Now, PUBG was not the first Battle Royale game. It was definitely, at that time, the biggest and most detailed, which is what drew people to it from the alternatives like H1Z1 and Minecraft Hunger Games. Following its success, PUBG got a mobile port in March of 2018, an Xbox One port in September, and a PS4 port in December. So where does that put it now? Well, across all the platforms, PUBG has sold over 50 million copies, and it's still one of the most played games on Steam, boasting daily peak player counts of over 600,000 people. At number 2, Grand Theft Auto 5. GTA 5 is not only one of the best-selling games of all time, but it's also one of the most expensive, which you probably knew because of its insane marketing push before launch. There were GTA 5 billboards, commercials, every 5 feet. There was something about this game, and it paid off because after sinking a staggering $265 million in the game's development, Rockstar shattered sales records on launch day, grossing $800 million in that day alone. And it's still continuing to sell copies and get new players to this day thanks to the ports and the updates. Heck, GTA 5 is still one of the top 10 most played games on Steam almost 5 years after its PC release. The game launched on the PS3 and the Xbox 360 on September 17th of 2013. Then got an enhanced port over to the PS4 and the Xbox One the next year. Then the PC version the next year after that. When you add all those versions up, guess what you get? 115 million copies sold. 115 million. And this is only number 2. And at number 1 today, good old consistent Minecraft. After a few years in beta, Minecraft launched in November of 2011 on Mac, PC, Linux, Android, and iOS. This was before sandbox games were really commonplace, so it was very addicting. There was a certain pull to Minecraft that it was hard to put your finger on. Very few games at the time gave you that much control over how you wanted to play, and word of mouth quickly spread Minecraft around. So in May of 2012, the game was ported to the Xbox 360. In December of 2013, it was on the PS3, and things only got bigger. In September of 2014, it was ported to the PS4 and the Xbox One, then to the PS Vita the following month. Then, a brand new Windows 10 version in mid-2015. And then, a Wii U version in 2015. And then, a Switch version. I could do this all day. Then, a 3DS version, so on and so forth. The point is, it's everywhere. Has full cross-play support. Makes it one of the more appealing games for new players. It's a prime example of what can be done when someone has a unique idea for a game and puts their mind to it and doesn't compromise for the sake of what a big publisher wants them to do. Across all versions, Minecraft has sold over 180 million copies and is currently the best-selling game of all time and, of course, the best-selling game of this decade. There you have it, my friends. Let me know one game that you really enjoyed that you thought was going to be on this list, but it didn't make it. As always, there are two videos up on the screen. You have a choice to make right now. A crossroads. Well, a cross in the roads. Yeah, you get what I'm saying. You got to pick A or B. Whichever one you pick, I'll see you over there on the video.